Hello there guys, my name is Jensen, and before we get started this video, I'd just like to let you guys know that I'm very sorry for not uploading for the past couple, well, for a month now, and that is due to school, work, and just a whole bunch of other activities that doesn't have to do with YouTube. So, the videos are going to start grinding out right now, so without further ado, let's hop right into the new video. Hello there guys, my name is Jensen and today we are going to be going over how to record and edit your videos on an iMac or iMac software. Now the first thing you want to do is locate your QuickTime player. Now this is going to be our recording software, and now this could be in your dock or it could be in your Finder. Now it's impossible to not find it because this is a default application that comes built in with your new iMac. Now once you have found it, make sure to select the non-paying version because we do not want to pay to make videos. Now the next thing you want to do is make sure that's selected, click on file, and there's going to be three different types of recording methods that you can do. Now movie is for face cam, audio is for voiceovers, and then the screen is to record the screen. So once you have selected the one that confronts your video, you're going to want to make sure to set it up with any external or internal microphones that you are going to use, and if you are using the making a new movie option, then select the external or internal face cam or face cams that you might be using. Now in our case we are going to be doing a screen recording, and you're going to want to, now the neat thing about this is that you can actually select the properties. So what you want to do of your recording space, you want to click on record, and then you can select the area. Now this is nice because then you can block up some private information that you do not want the public to see. Now I understand that this might be what most people want. In my case, I'm not so afraid of that, since I'm not the only Jensen in this world. But, yeah. So now once you have done so, you can just do your tutorial or whatever, and then you want to click on the little bar on that represents it, and then click stop recording. It'll pop up. And now once you have done so, save it to the name and on the desktop, which is the best spot to put it at. Now the next thing you want to do is open up your iMovie. The reason why there was a transition there was actually because iMovie takes forever to open. Now once you have done so, you want to let it open up and then click on new movie. Then once you have done so, it will pop up a window asking for themes, and I just do no themes because that could potentially ruin your project. And once you have done so, it will just open up your project, and then you can drag your file down below. Now before doing so, you don't have your file, so you need to import it. So click on import, the import button, and then locate and so double click on your project. Now once you have done so, you want to drag your video or audio clip down into the project viewer. Now once you have done so, what I would recommend doing now is actually editing your video, because a video without editing doesn't really look so good at the end. So add your transitions or titles or whatever. I recommend adding as a transition cross dissolves on both ends, which is what I do every single time I make a video. Like it's the first thing I do when editing a video. Next, you can, if you're that good at editing already, you can select your colors or like a certain color that matches your video, then go down file and then share and then file. Now the reason why we did not just do it directly to YouTube is because the quality will be intensely downgraded than just simply doing it to your desktop directly and then going on YouTube's website. Then you want to select the certain where you want it to go, and then it'll start to export. Now this can take some time to export depending on the length and what you have open while recording. Okay, now what you want to do right after is wait. Now this waiting process can take a long time, so I would recommend go grabbing something and drinking or eating it. Now once you have done so, you can go to YouTube's website, sign in, and then upload your video, put the title, and you're good to go. Anyways guys, hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial, and hey, why don't you go try making a YouTube video while you're at it? You have time? If you have time to watch this video, I think you might have time to make a video. So hey, let's see that. I can't wait to see your guys' channels get bigger and better. And I hope you guys enjoyed. Please do leave a like rating and commenting and also subscribing to stay informed whenever I upload. So hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.